When you look at carbon capture and sequestration, one of the big things that you hear all the time is that it's too expensive. And so one of the things that Quest is trying to do is be very cost effective with this. And we recognize that the early projects may not get 100% of that right, but really trying to set that stage. And so one of the big things that we're doing on Quest is actually taking our modularization to what I would say the next level. And one of the things that Shell brings to this is and some of our contractors is really looking at how can we do this differently that will actually reduce our cost. And so the concept we're looking at for Quest is really to use some of the offshore techniques where the space is limited, but height may not be as big of a deal, and really the weight restrictions. And so when you look at how we've designed Quest, we've gotten away from what I would call the spine and modules off to the side. So that main pipe rack with all of our units sitting to the side has gone away, and what we now have is a very integrated, very tight design, which is more cost effective. It also brings a challenge for our module yards in Alberta to actually fit everything into the size that we can actually transport on the roadways here. But with that, we also have an advantage because there's a heavy load corridor in Alberta that allows us to bring in fairly supersized modules within that corridor and take it to Scotford. So I'd say it's about 8 times the volume of what we could transport if it had to come from outside the province. So I think from a skill set perspective, we're looking at building some capacity in Alberta to build these super modules, but also taking the design aspect, that extra step, so that we don't spread out as much and hence use less material to actually build the facility.